So what happened is, I get the call this morning that he's been arrested at his hotel room. I go straight to the police, the sheriff's department here, and, you know, start putting the pieces together on what's going on and how to fix it. So I was, I'm sure you could tell by my tweeting, I was 100% confident that I was going to get him out for this fight. So basically what happened is they do not like him in Des Moines, Iowa, where this warrant is from. And basically, you know, he's in one of those, you know, they're going to extradite him, one of those situations down, or not. We'll see what happens with this whole thing. But, you know, the kid's been here since Monday. No secret that he was going to be here Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. They arrest him almost at noontime on Friday after he weighs in yesterday and everything else happens. So, in my opinion, after dealing with this all day, that was done on purpose, number one. Number two, I cut the deal with the people down in Des Moines, Iowa, to get him out. Done deal. We cut the deal. I agree to it. We're going to get him out. They changed the deal. Okay. Well, I accept that deal, too. They changed the deal. Every time they would lay out a new deal, I would accept it, and they would change it. They kept trying to make it harder and harder and harder. You know what I mean? And then you know me, especially after I tweeted, you know, the media to shut up, and this fight, you knew this fight I was going to do. I was devising a plan to break him out and come over here and do this fight. I'm going to support my guy, but you don't have to be Rampage or John Jones or some of the big stars in the UFC. If you're in the UFC and you're in here and you've helped us and you know, you're a fighter here, I'm going to support you. I'm going to have your back, depending on how serious, you know, the matter is.
Can I ask why you were so adamant about having him fight? Because it seems a lot of people were saying, hey, even if the guy gets out, he's probably in no mind frame to be fighting.
Two regular people. Two people, you know, people that are sitting home, all big deal. It's a big deal to him. This kid isn't John Jones or Rampage. Do you know what losing this purse means to a kid like Jeremy Stevens? It's a huge blow. This is how these guys make a living. This is how they feed their families. This is, you know, he spent money to get to this fight. Money he probably didn't have. And now he's really screwed because the fight didn't happen. I was willing to have two police officers, armed police officers, bring him from jail to come fight tonight and then bring him back to jail. Let's do that. Let the kid get paid because he's going to have to spend money on this thing anyway. You know, he's got a family to take care of. It's just crazy. I've seen crazier shit than this. Floyd Mayweather got to decide when he went to jail. You know what I mean? But this kid on an assault charge couldn't come out and fight today. When he would have gone back to jail, I would have bailed him out. I would have flew him to Des Moines, Iowa to face the charges down there. I was willing to do anything. And they dragged me out and played games with me all day. So that's why I'm so pissed, and that's why I was so about it today on Twitter too. You know? I hate seeing stuff like this happen to the guys, you know? And yeah, there's no doubt he's responsible for the situation. But again, he's got a completely different story. We all have different stories when we're in trouble, you know? But I was trying to help him.
I guess last question on that topic. Can you reveal what you decided to do financially for him and for Yves?
Yeah, oh, and that. Yves Edwards, just to show you how much I thought this was going to happen, Yves Edwards was told 35 minutes before the main event that his fight wasn't on. That kid was wrapped up, warmed up, and ready to fight. And he's an old school, you know, it's guys like Yves Edwards that have built this sport to what it is today. These are the guys that I'm talking about that helped us get it where it is today. It's an honor to be in business with a guy like Yves Edwards. Some of these new guys, man, my head's all f***ed up. I can't take this fight now. Yves Edwards was in that locker room ready to fight, you know, and I respect him and I appreciate him. He'll be paid his show money, and then we'll get him a fight. I don't care if we have 37 fights on one card. Coming up here soon, Yves Edwards will be on it.
Watch post-fight interviews and unaired prelims only on UFC.com.